All right, folks, back at it here on Pine Creek with the fly rod. And actually, I was here with the guys on Saturday, and we were fishing here. Fishing was a little slow, and it's Tuesday afternoon here. I'm actually staying up here at the cabin this week to turkey hunt. Didn't really expect to be coming over here to pine at all this week, but the water's actually in good condition. I didn't think it would be. That's why I wasn't expecting to really be able to fish. I figured I'd just be turkey hunting in the mornings and then afternoons just be hanging out at the cabin. But water's in good shape, so I figured, got done turkey hunting this morning, so I figured why not come over here to Pine Creek and give it a try again. So got a few hours to fish here this afternoon and evening, and beautiful stretch of water out here in front of me, one of my favorite spots. So we'll get to fishing here, see what we can catch today. All right, folks, so I had one fish here on a sculpin that I lost, had one other hit, but there's a fish out here in front of me that's rising, so I think I'm gonna try dry fly there. It just rose right there. I'm gonna get on something here, see if I can't catch that fish. There he was again. I think I'm gonna try the Hendrickson. He's feeding out there pretty consistent, and hopefully this will work. Have yet to land a fish on a dry fly this year, so maybe this will be the night. All right, here we go, folks. Let's give this fish a try. Oh, he went right next to mine. That was right over top of him, but he rose right before my fly got there. All right, guys, the Hendrickson didn't work, so I'm gonna try Quill Gordon here. That fish is still out there rising pretty consistently. You'll probably be able to see him here pretty soon. There we go, guys, got him. Nice. Took the Quill Gordon. Look at that jump. First one on a dry fly of the year, and he crushed that thing. Let's see if I can land him. Nice brown trout. This is actually what Tyler caught his fish on Saturday. He caught one fish on the surface, and this is what it was on. The good old Quill Gordon. He's fighting pretty good. Look at that. Beautiful brown trout. Look at that fish. Beautiful looking fish. Quill Gordon right there. Beautiful brown trout, guys. Beautiful Pine Creek brown. Let's get him back. There he goes.
All right, guys, that was pretty awesome right there. First fish I caught this year on a dry fly. A lot of fun. What's interesting about that right there is, like I said, I caught that fish on a Quill Gordon. It's April 30th, last day April here on Pine Creek in Tioga County, Pennsylvania. And Quill Gordons are one of the hatches that's going on right now on Pine. And there's tons of Quill Gordons and Hendricksons hatching right now. I mean, there's a whole bunch of them coming down the water. What's interesting there is that is the only fish that has been rising. There's not a single other fish that I've seen rise in this whole stretch. And that one was rising consistently. Why that is, I'm not sure. Why the other fish aren't hitting them, I don't know. That fish, I guess, just wanted to feed on the surface right now. Figured he's probably hitting one of those two flies. And the other part is that it took me several times of drifting that fly over that fish till he ate it, because every single time I was throwing it over him, it was usually either too soon or too late after he had hit his last fly. He's coming up about the same amount of time in between each rise, so you kind of have to time it right to where when your fly's going over him is when he's ready to come up and get his next fly. So finally, after several drifts over him, I timed it right. He nailed it, set the hook. There he was. Beautiful brown trout too. We'll get to fishing here. I don't know what I guess I can't really fish a dry fly anymore. There's no fish feeding on the surface anymore, so I don't know what I'm going to do, if I'm going to go back to the sculpin or what, but I'll figure out something here and see if I can't hook into a couple more.
All right, guys, so what happened is I actually lost another fish on a sculpin, and he snapped me off. I started walking back upstream here to fish this run again, and I spotted this fish about halfway out right out here that started rising. So put the Quill Gordon back on, and we're going to see if we can get him.
Got him, guys. Yes. Nice little rainbow. Another one on the quill, Gordon. How about that? Oh, there we go. Oh, that's awesome. There's a look at him. Decent little rainbow. Once again, just had to time it right. Once I timed it right, he nailed it. And there he goes.
All right, folks, so just released that fish. We are 2 for 2 on the quill, Gordons. Only two fish I've seen rising all evening. Caught them both, and that one was pretty cool. I actually wasn't expecting, he hit it a lot lower than what I thought he was gonna, so it kind of surprised me on the hook set there, but luckily still got him hooked. Now all I need is for the rest of these fish to start feeding, because I already know what they want. So I don't know what I'm gonna do here, if I'm gonna wait for another fish to start rising, if I'm gonna tie a sculpin back on or what, but I'll try to figure something out. But it'd be nice if the rest of these things started feeding, because I'd love to catch a whole bunch of them on these quill Gordons.
All right, guys, hooked up again here on a olive woolly bugger. Another rainbow. Right out here in this nice run. There he is. Pretty solid rainbow too, that thing. Nice and fat, healthy fish. Olive woolly bugger right there in the top. There he goes. There he is, guys. Saw fish feeding. Threw the quill Gordon back on. First cast that I got it over him, he crushed it. There he is, guys. Look at that fish. Beautiful brownie on the quill Gordon. Fourth fish of the night, 3 for 3 on quill Gordons. Back he goes.
Well, guys, it isn't too often that you get it figured out like this. It feels pretty good when you do, but this is a situation where every time I've thrown a quill Gordon at a rising fish, I've caught that fish, which it's only been 3 times. Normally, it's the other way around. Normally, in fly fishing, it seems like here on Pine, we have lots of fish rising, and it's a little bit tougher to figure out what they want to feed on. Now, tonight, I kind of got lucky, I guess. That is the one thing that I like about this time of year. Still a little bit early in the season, late April, and there's only a couple different mayfly hatches happening, so that when you do have fish rising, they can be a little bit easier to figure out versus, like, say, for example, in the middle of May, when there's just so many different mayflies hatching, you have fish feeding, it takes longer to figure out what those fish want. So anyways, still got the quill Gordon on here, waiting to look for another fish here that rises, but landed 3 on the quill Gordon, 3 for 3, landed that one on the olive bugger, lost maybe at least 3 or 4 on the olive bugger also. So fish are feeding here pretty good tonight, so we'll keep after it here. Got another hour or so to fish and see if we can't land a couple more.
Beautiful sunset going down over Pine Creek behind me, guys. Gotta love this stuff. Beautiful scenery here on Pine. Had a good night tonight. Caught some nice trout. First fish of the year on a dry fly, and just had a lot of fun out here. So I'm gonna call it a night now. Thank you guys for watching. We'll catch you guys on the next video. And now I'm gonna head out and try to shoot a turkey tomorrow morning. Guess we'll see how that goes.